answering the MCQs pattern. And along with that, we will do just one or two examples. After that, you can have the examples from your own books. And today, one more book I'm going to upload that contains more of the thing along with the examples, how to do it on the Excel. Shubham, you want to say something? Anjivi, to bole. Okay. You are saying to send all the PPTs in NPO Life. It's fine. Whatever the material I have delivered till now, it's all with me. I can upload it on LPU Live. So might be those who have not downloaded or you are not having the whole sequence, you can go through it. And obviously it will be helpful to you in going through the PPTs in order to prepare for the MTEs. Right? So when we will take near about 2 to 3 minutes break in between the class, I will upload it in the time. Because otherwise it might be possible that I'm not remembering the things. So I will upload it and you have to go from the PPTs also. Okay. So still the students are joining. Now we have 12 of the students on Google Meet and here we have 15 of you. So let us start. I think it's 3-5, and in between if somebody will come to join us, it's fine. Otherwise, I will assume that might be they are not interesting to go for the things along with the other group, because in the lecture class tomorrow, I will start from the next topic because we have to cover the course also. And for the group, I'm actually not sure, but those students who have joined on the MyClass platform, I want to ask you that is it possible again that you can join along with the other students? I think you are group one, no? Whatever the group is again, the other students have the slot of practical on Saturday 3 to 5. So is it possible that you can join over there along with them? If you will be free? Okay, then fine, that's very good. So that we can elaborate the topic in detail if possible, because then we will not be in hurry. So total 5 hours are enough, because if we go for the 5 lectures, then they are enough actually to cover the whole topic. So that's fine. You have to then join on the Google Meet when the other group will be here for the MyClass platform. Okay? So let me start with the things. Here we have the next unit to be started, analysis of variance and experimental design. So what we are going to do here in this course, in this unit is that till now when we have done with the t-test, you might be aware of that we have gone for the t-test along with the mean or for the difference of mean. This we have done. And if we talk about what we have done over there is, so for t-test, we have taken a population. We have taken 2 samples. Whenever the sample size is less than 30, or you can say less than equal to 30. And in that case, we have analyzed the things over there that either the difference of mean or is significant or not regarding these 2 samples. Until now, whether we have gone for the Z test or T test, maximum number of samples that we have taken is 2. You, all of you might be aware of it, right? Either the mean or the difference of mean that we have done. Now, what we are doing here in ANOVA is, ANOVA is actually created to work for those hypotheses to be checked for the claim in which we have the sample means to be verified are more than 2. Might be this time we are going to have 3 different samples or 4 different samples, or could be more than that. Correct? So whenever we are going only for the maximum of 2 samples, then here I can apply the t-test or z-test. Normally we go for the t-test, as already I have told you that in practical we are not going for the z-test. Practical means in the real life examples. I'm not talking about your CAP practical, no. I'm talking about the t-test. Correct? But when we have the number of samples are more than 2, so in that case, whatever the tests we have learned till now are not applicable, and in that case, we have to go for ANOVA and other based experimental design. Now, why we are calling it as experimental design is because most of the time, analysis of variance is required whenever we are working in the experiments, means we are doing some experiment, I want to see the effect of one thing on another, and the categories are more than two. So in that case, whatever the design we are going to take for this hypothesis to be checked, that is just like an experiment. And since it is more than two, we are going to work on ANOVA. That's why we are combining the two topics together, ANOVA. Why we are calling it as ANOVA? It is taken from this analysis of variance, ANOVA. This is just the short form of analysis of variance, ANOVA. And we are going for the experimental design because based upon which type of experiment we are doing, we can have the results. We have to check the hypothesis, the claim, for the more than two samples that we are going to visualize. Right? So let us start with the topic. Hope so all of those who have joined the Google Meet have no problem. We are getting the things. One more thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take it on the full screen so that if the things are not clear to you, you will be able to see it more clearly. Right? Let me make it full screen. Still the students are joining. That's the only problem when we used to take the Google Meet. So let us make it now full screen so that we can start with the presentation. And whenever you have any problem, obviously you can take your speaker on and ask me, right? Because I will not be able to see what you are going to write on in the chat box. So let us start with the same analysis of variance and experimental design. So here, what we are going to learn is, the first thing is we are going to learn the concept of ANOVA. What is analysis of variance? Along with that, we have to learn how designs can be created for the experiments. And in that, we have to calculate and interpret results of completely randomized design, which is called as CRD. Completely C, randomized gives R, and design gives D. CRD, which is actually one type of ANOVA known as one-way ANOVA. And normally, if we talk about ANOVA from the students, those who are not aware of the experimental designs, then they know about the classification of ANOVA as either one-way ANOVA or two-way ANOVA. They are not aware of, about the other things as experimental design. So this is the normal classification of ANOVA, either one way or two way. But since we are going to read the same concept in depth, so here we are going to learn CRD is the name for the one way ANOVA, which is known as completely randomized design. And then we have another thing as randomized block design. Again, it falls into the category of one way ANOVA, but normally when we are not talking about anything, then CRD is taking as by default thing for one-way ANOVA. Then we have Latin square design. This is an approach in which how to do the manipulation, how to experiment the design, that we will discuss and we'll learn about ANOVA again. And here if we talk about factorial design, then only this falls into the category which is known as two-way ANOVA. Correct? So this is what we have as a one-way ANOVA or a two-way ANOVA. Just will switch off your speaker, beta. Justin, switch off your speaker, beta. I have done it. Fine. So this is what we are going to learn. For the two-way ANOVA, we have only one thing in course, factorial design. And whatever other things we are going to learn is actually a part of one-way ANOVA. But in some of the books, some authors are saying that RBD is falling into the two-way ANOVA and so on, but actually it is not so. So this is what we are going to follow. Might be different books have the different opinions, but we are going to take only FD as two-way ANOVA and whatever other things I have discussed, CRD, RBD and LD, because these are the three topics that we have to learn in this course for one way and over. You can just note it down as a brief because you are going for the MCQ pattern. So you must have to write down your own notes other than the PPT. So if you talk about CRD, RBD, randomized block design, and LD, they are falling under the heading of one way and over. And if you talk about FD, factorial design, that it falls under the two way and over. Correct. So till now we have learned just the headings and what is ANOVA, analysis of variance. Now, if we talk about the simple definitions, if we talk about what experimental design is and whatever the other definitions. Now, here the definitions are also very important. Why they are important? Because here we are going to learn them and some of the MCQs can be framed directly from them. Right? So, if we talk about experimental design, so it is the logical construction of an experiment to test the hypothesis in which the researcher either control or manipulate one or more variable. Suppose I'm a researcher and I want to find out what is the effect of a particular quality of wheat on the yield. Particular quality of seeds, might be I'm going to take wheat crops to be sown. So I can take the different varieties and I'm going to note down whatever their yield is. Okay? So whenever we are designing some of the experiment, now how I can do is, might be I have three varieties of seeds, right? And I'm going to sow them. So whatever the varieties of seeds are, let me take, we have variety A, B, and C. I want to find out which of the varieties is giving me more yield. But obviously when we are going to sow them, so soil quality also matter, urea also matter, a lot of other things are there. So if I'm going to take some of the treatments, either I'm going to give them same type of urea or I'm going to vary the urea quality also, urea of type 1, urea of type 2, urea of type 3 and so on. So this is what I'm constructing as a design of my experiment, that I want to experiment these three type of seeds of wheat to plot and find out their output. But along with that, I'm taking the urea also. Or might be I'm going to take in the different field. I can take in one field because we know that soil quality could be different and based upon that we can get the effect. So I can take in one field, in second field, in the third field. Right? So whenever these type of things we are going to experiment with, obviously we have to think for which type of experiment I'm going to do and I have to create some experimental design. Right? Hope so you are getting some of the idea. Now let us talk about the widely used terms. Now these terms are very important because as a theory, if we have to ask some of the things, we can ask from you in the definition form. Then what do you mean by treatment? What do you mean by factor? And the different options will be given. Right? I'm giving you a very clear idea because if we talk about the numericals, then in numericals also only the basic concepts can be asked. Otherwise, the whole procedure cannot be asked from you. Because this time we do not have any subjective question. So if we talk about treatment variable, it is a variable which is controlled or modified by a researcher in the experiment. So here if we talk about, I want to analyze the variety of three seeds. So what these three are, these are the treatments I am going to give to the soil. Okay. For example, here we have written, in agriculture, the different fertilizers or different methods of cultivations are the treatments. Because normally ANOVA come into the picture for the agriculture students, those who are doing with some experiment. That's why most of the time when you will open the books, you will also get the examples related to the agriculture field. So hope so you are clear about the treatment. Whatever thing is controlled or modified by the researcher in the experiment is known as a treatment. If you talk about the next related definition after a treatment, so here we have classification variable. Classification variable is defined as a characteristic of experimental subject that are present prior to the experiment and not a result of researcher manipulation or control. Now, when I have discussed you an example, I'm talking about the soil quality. So here, if you talk about soil, so are I going to manipulate the soil? No, it's not possible. Different cities have their different type of soils which are available over there as per the geographical location. So I am not able to alter it. But yes, if soil is a variable, I can alter the quality of fertilizer, I can alter the quality of seed. So the thing that can be altered is a treatment. I'm giving this treatment, and if I talk about the soil, so I am not able to control it. Obviously, I can give them the urea, the fertilizer, that is again a treatment. But if you talk about the thing which is already present, so it is the same thing. Classification variable is a characteristic of experimental subject that are present prior to the experiment and not as a result of researcher manipulation or control. Correct? If you have any of the doubt, you can let me know. According to me, I have told you regarding what a treatment is and what a variable is. Now, if you talk about experimental unit, what is the unit on which we are going to apply? It is the smallest division of experimental material to which treatment are applied and observation are made, is known as the experimental unit. Now, in this example, what I have started with, if you talk about the seeds, so we are talking about field, whatever the fields I have taken. So here, field is an experimental unit, because this is the part where I'm going to sow the crops. Correct? Now next is factor. Now here you have to be very clearly note down the example in your notebook regarding the things are very much common in the treatment and when I talk about the factor. Let us read it out. A factor can be referred to as a set of treatments of a single type. In most situations, a researcher may be interested in studying more than one factor. Correct? Now, here, if I'm talking about the same example, let me take. I have the different fields in which I'm going to sow these three things: seed A, seed B, seed C. Might be these are the variety of weeds. Now, when I'm taking seeds into the consideration, these are treatment, as I already have discussed, that these are the treatments. Now, might be I have taken some seed. Along with that, I want to take some fertilizer. So this is one of the treatment. This is another of the treatment. Correct? So whatever the set of treatments we are going to take, set of treatment means seed quality I'm going to change. Correct? Single type means I'm talking about seeds, I'm talking about fertilizers, I'm talking about some other thing. These type of things, whatever I'm going to take in experiments, constitute the factor. Correct. So be sure to refer to the things as treatment and factor very carefully because these things often make the student confused about the things and lead to the incorrect answers. Right. So this is to be very carefully written along with the examples. For more detail, I will upload today the book in which most of the things are given, and I'm also taking from that book, so I will share it with you. These all theory part I have taken from Business Stats by Nobel Vajpayee. So that ebook I have downloaded, I am going to share with you. It is the first edition of that book, and from which I have copied is also the same, but I have actually a hard copy of the second edition. So that is the only change. Okay. So if we talk about ANOVA, till now we have talked about experimental design. What do you mean by the experimental design? Which type of things could be there? What are the things that need to be altered and so on? No? So if we talk about these things, we have done with just the base of the experimental design. In order to start with how to work on experimental design, we have ANOVA, which is a technique of testing hypothesis about significance difference in several population mean. Several population mean means obviously more than two population or the two samples. So here also I have written that it is extension of two independent sample t-test. Here we have worked with the two samples, and here I am going to work with more than two samples or more than two populations. Now these are also very important. Mark it as very important. It could be asked in theory as well as in an MCQ.
Excuse me, ma'am.
हाँ जी बिल्कुल
मैम मैम आपने अभी जस्ट थोड़ी देर पहले बोला था ना मैम कि लाइक लिसन फ्रॉम योर केयरफुली मैम, उसी समय मैं डिसकनेक्ट हो गई थी मैम। प्लीज थोड़ा सा अगर समरी आप जल्दी से बता दो तो।
बेटा इफ पॉसिबल यू कैन गो थ्रू द रिकॉर्डिंग आफ्टर दैट। मुझे अब ये नहीं पता आपने कहाँ से मिस किया, व्हाट यू हैव मिस्ड, टेल मी व्हाट यू हैव मिस्ड सो दैट आई कैन गो थ्रू इट बैक। आयशा व्हाट यू हैव मिस्ड, Are you there? So let me continue. Here Devang is saying factor ek bar aur repeat kar dijiye. So I will, let me do that. Okay? Let me repeat whatever is possibility. Otherwise, the topic is very elaborate. We already discussed here. So when you will go through the things,
okay, ma'am.
I should tell me from where the things are not clear to you. So let me take you from factors. Here we are discussing about that when we are taking a single, you can say a factor. Single factor means a set of treatment. Means if I am taking seeds, I am going to alter the quality of seeds and note down how much yield is coming from the fields. So the first thing that we are going to alter is seeds. It is one of the factor. If I am going to alter the fertilizer, I can apply on the same seed. Might be I'm working on same field and I have made them in the first part, second part and third part. So what will happen? Soil quality will remain same. I have divided my field into three parts. And here in first part, I can sow seed A. I can sow seed B in the second part and third, I can sow third variety. Now along with the fertilizer, if I want to do, I can do one more thing. That might be I have two varieties, urea 1 and urea 2. Then what I can do, I want to see the effect of urea 1 and 2 on variety A because it is the same field, so soil quality is fixed. Again, I can sow some of the seeds with urea 1, some of the seeds with urea 2. So here I am going to work on urea as well as I am going to work on seeds. So these two are the factors. Seed and urea are the two factors. Seeds, all variety of seeds are making one treatment and variety of urea is making the other treatment. Okay? So this is what the difference between the factor and treatments are. Then we have talked about this, the same definition that ANOVA means analysis of variance, and it is to be used when we are working with the more than two sample means. Okay? Then this is, I have told you to note it down and listen very carefully regarding the assumptions. Because again, from these assumptions, a simple MCQ can be framed that you have to answer. Okay? Because if it is in subjective part coming, so obviously the question is, what are the assumptions of ANOVA, which is very simple and important topic. And if you talk about MCQ, then these options can be given with the alteration and we can ask you, which of the option is incorrect or correct. Correct. So what are the assumptions are? The first is independent of cases. Whatever samples we are going to draw for the analysis, they should be independent of each other. Correct. Whatever we are going to take should be independent, randomly taken. Means when I'm going to analyze the fact, then I'm not biased upon that I have to take sample from this or this part. No, it should be randomly taken. The second assumption is normality. Whatever the values we are going to take from each group should be normal. These are the assumption. We are not going to check it in the numerical. Correct? And the third one is equality, which is also known as homogeneity of variance. Means whatever the data we will have from the different treatments results, whatever data we will have, we are assuming that the variance of each and every population is equal. This is an assumption. I'm not going to say it is equal. I'm assuming it. The equality of variance is an assumption when we have to apply the ANOVA. Correct? So be sure to mark it because these are very simple independence of case, normality and homogeneity or equality of variances. And obviously it can be asked in an MCQ. Now we have some of the things that you have to just listen, because whenever we are going to work with ANOVA, these are the theory part that we have to cover. It's not actually the theory. It is all based upon the how we are going to do the calculation. So let me first talk about the variance. Okay, till now, if I have worked with the variance, you remember where we have worked with the formula? In the F test. Whenever we have worked with variances, it was the F test that has given me the answer that the variance of the populations are same or they are different. So here we are going to apply the formula for the F test. But in order to reach at a point where we can apply the F test, a lot of calculation part is required. Now how we are going to start is, the first thing is components of the total variation. As I told you that we are going to learn about the variance. So how the variance is to be calculated, this is that component we are talking about. So if we talk about in ANOVA, the total variation in the sample data can be account of two components. So you can just write down that whatever the total variation is there in the data values, it is divided under two parts. One is variance between samples and variance within the samples. Now let me tell you how we are talking about between and variance within. Suppose I have collected the samples as a result of A treatment, B treatment, C treatment from some field. Now I want to find out, as we all of us, I think you all are aware of what is the variance. Variance means difference from the mean. How much difference are the values from the mean? And we all know how to calculate the variance. Here also we are talking about the same variance, but here we are talking about two type of variances. Might be possible that the variance are between the samples. Between the samples means what is the variance of the data is collected from variety of seed A and then the variety of seed B. It is between A and B. Similarly, we can have between B and C, or we can have between C and A. So this means of between the samples. Within the sample means whatever data values we are collecting as a result of the seeds A, because we have taken the data, not only one, only a single data cannot be taken, obviously. Whatever data values I have connected for the variety of the yield got from seed A. So here also there is a change depending upon the conditions. So whenever we are talking about in the sample, how much variation is coming from the same variety of seed, that is within the samples. Now here we have again written in bold for the purpose of clarifying it. Variance between sample is attributed to the difference among the sample means, different among the samples means, and it is due to some assignable causes. Assignable causes means, obviously, here we have the variety A, here we have the variety B, here we have the variety C. So these are the assignable causes that we have assigned, and then we are looking for the variation between them. Another is variance within sample. I have collected all the data values that we are getting from one sample, and we are getting a different value. Might be from variety A, I am taking the yield of the wheat in one of the areas coming as 23, another is coming as 12, or let me take 22, another is coming as 19. Obviously some variation is there in between. Now why we are getting this variation? There is no such reason. It is just difference due to chance or some experimental errors. It is just by chance. Okay. So these are the two type of variance that occur when we are looking for the total variation in ANOVA to be calculated. Hope so the things are clear. Be sure to again write it down, because these two things are very important, and it will go for the whole whatever four types of ANOVA we are going to learn. This total variation is coming there also, and might be they are going to be divided in more than two components. This is just the basic. that the total variation is divided between the samples and within the samples. Between the sample, it is due to the difference among the sample means, and within the sample is just to some experimental error or just by chance. Correct? So this is what we mean by the total variation components. Then I have just pasted out one of the slide that will come at the end when we were done through the whole process. And why I have pasted out, because when I was creating PPT, so it just come to my mind that when I will tell you about SSC, SSC, SST, then students might have an excitement or a question, why we are learning all these. You know, this is an obvious question that comes to my mind. So this is actually the last slide of the whole procedure. I have just pasted over here to let you know what calculation we are going to do. As a final thing, we need to calculate this F value that gives me a value of F, which I'm going to compare with the F standard value in order to find out that the hypothesis is accepted or rejected. This is just as we have done in the hypothesis testing. Before that, a lot of things need to be calculated. That includes some of the terms like SSC, SSE, SST, the degree of freedoms as we have calculated till now. Then there are two more terms, mean squares. MS stands for mean square. MSC means this SSC divided by K minus 1. MSE means SSE divided by N minus K. Now, what are these things? We will learn, obviously. But here, just an outline I'm giving you as a summary that these things we are going to learn. So actually, what we are going to do is we need to calculate SSC and SSE, whose total is given by SST. If I calculate these three things, then by our knowledge, we will write down what their degrees of freedoms are. Then on dividing SSC by K minus 1, I will take MSE value. Dividing SSC by N minus K, I will get MSE value. And dividing these two values, we will get the value of F. On comparing this F value with the standard value, we will come to know that our hypothesis is accepted or rejected. Okay, now what these values are? SSC means sum of square between columns. Now what is sum of square? All of you are aware of how to calculate variance. You know, x minus x bar square divided by n or n minus 1. Normally we have taken n. So here we are talking about sum of square. If I take summation of the squares of the deviation. So that is what the meaning of sum of square. Now when we are talking about between columns, it means whatever the data values are, if I am going to talk about the difference in the columns, that is SSC. Sum of square within sample, if I am talking about a single column and I need to calculate what is the difference in within the sample, that is SSE, which is happening just due to errors. Now we have learned that it is just by chance or due to some error. So that is SSE. And if I sum the two things, SSC and SSE, I will get the sum of square of total, that is SST. Right? Now here we have degree of freedoms that we will again learn in detail. It is just a summary. Now what the degree of freedom is, if we have K values of the treatments, if we are applying K treatments, then here the degree of freedom will be K minus 1. Or we can say if we have the K columns, some of the books have represented this by C also. So that we will come to know about the columns. C minus 1, if we have the total data values as N, then N minus C will be create the degree of freedom of the within columns. And then if I add the two, because last column is just to be created by ourselves, last row, sorry. So if I add the two, K and K will cancel out. And as a total, what we will get is N minus 1. And you remember in the t-test, if we have N data values, degree of freedoms are N minus 1. So here also they are the same, but we are getting it as a total of K minus 1 and N minus K. Then after, it is just the simplification, this by this give me this value, this by this give me this value, and dividing the two, you will give me F value. It means what we have to concentrate on? We have to concentrate on how we are going to calculate SSC and SSE. Correct? And after that, the whole procedure will be same in the example also, whatever the values are given to you. So let us start with how to calculate the SSC. And here we have taken the heading of CRD, because till now whatever we have learned, it will be common to all the procedure. Almost it will be same in RBD, in LSD and FD. The procedure will remain the same. Most of the things will be common. And here, whatever now we are going to learn, or what we have seen actually, is falling under the heading of CRD. And why it is known as completely randomized design is because here, whatever the design we are going to take in, it is just random design. Means we are not bothered about how we are going to give a particular treatment to a particular unit. Obviously, some things need to be taken care of, but it is just randomly granted. It means if you talk about the fields and the seeds, let me take treatment A, B, C are the three different varieties of seeds. Then I'm not saying so that in this particular part, I'm going to take this, this or this. No, it is just randomly selected. Right? So that's why it is known as completely randomized design. Right? So this is what we have. Now, if we read it down, what the important definition we have written is that completely randomized design contain only one independent variable with two or more treatment level of classification. Here we are not saying two or more factors. We are saying two or more treatment levels or classification and one independent variable. Right? It means we can take any of the thing in which the different treatments are given. And again, it is treatment means the set of different things that we are going to experiment on. Okay. Now, this we have already learned that in CRD process, the sum of square, the total sum of square SST is divided into two parts, SSC and SSE. E means for error. Error means within a certain column, which is happening just by chance. And SSC means in between the different columns. So, hope so the nomenclatures are known to you. I'm just emphasizing on the same because these are the base of the whole ANOVA. And after this class, be sure to go through each and everything, because if something you will miss or it's not clear to you, then obviously, because the next RBD is going to include one more thing in the ANOVA. Similarly, LSD is just including of one more thing in ANOVA. And this is how we are going to work on it. So this is just the base. Here we have again the same thing. I have represented it in form of diagram in order so that you can visualize it. That whatever SST is, it is the sum of SSC and SSE. So let us start with the calculation. Here again, you have to just look upon it. It's all the theory part. How to solve it, I'm going to show it on the Excel. Because otherwise, it's very hard to do it manually. Whenever the question will come, it will come in 10 marks minimum because it is time consuming. But you have to learn the formulas. You have to learn the basics so that we will be able to do it on the Excel. In Excel, when you will do, you can do it in maximum of 10 to 20 minutes. Maximum of, obviously, it depends upon your speed. But yes, we need to calculate a lot of things. Let's just start with SSC. So here we have the first thing, how to calculate the total sum of squares. And when we talk about SSC, so obviously we must know how to calculate MSC, the mean square. And as we talk about SSC means between the columns we are going to work. If we have two or three, four columns, how many columns are there? We are going to work upon that column. So what the first thing is, calculate mean value of each column. Whatever the columns you have to calculate mean of this, mean of this, mean of this. Then you have to calculate the grand mean. Grand means if we have here x1 bar, mean of first one, mean of second one, mean of third one. Correct? So you have to find out the mean of all. And simply what we normally used to do is find out the sum of the first column, sum of the second column, sum of the third column. If I add the if I divide the sum by the number of entries in the first column, number of entries in the second column, and number of entries in the third column, I will get the individual column mean. And what we do for the grand mean is overall mean, add all the individual observation of the column and divide this by the total number of observation. Means you can say sum 1 plus sum 2 plus sum 3, whatever is coming, divided by n1 plus n2 plus n3. So this is our grand mean. So as a first step, what we have done, we have calculated the means x1 bar, x2 bar, x3 bar, and we have calculated the grand mean. Correct? Two things we have calculated. Now we have to find out is find the difference between the mean and the grand mean. Mean means x1 bar and the difference of this t, or we can represent it by x bar bar because it is the grand mean. In some of the books here also, I think we have the notation of x bar bar. So I'm going to find out the difference of x1 bar and x bar bar. We are going to find out the difference of x2 bar and x bar bar, and so on. How many columns are there depending upon that? After that, what you need to find out is we multiply these by the number of observation in the sample, square of these deviation and net them. If I tell you what we are going to do is here we have n1, n2, n3, the number of values in the first, second and third column. So here what we are going to do is take n1 to be multiplied with this deviation square plus number of terms in the second column, multiply with this deviation square plus n3 into x3 bar minus x bar bar square. This is how we are going to calculate the value, which is known as SSC. This is what we have to do. NJ, here we have written in terms of NJ into XJ bar minus X bar bar. They have represented the common thing as XJ. Right? J represents the number of columns. Now here we are talking about in the last step, the total obtained is divided by the degree of freedom, 1 less than the total number of samples. If there are K samples, the degree of freedom will be K minus 1. So this is how we have to calculate MSC. After calculating SSC, it is actually taken from the book. So that's why it's looking like this. Here we have the things that I have written in my own notes when I have created, because this topic we never have taught on the PPT. So I have created it with the help of book. Okay? So this is what we have to do. First, we have to calculate the mean values. We have to calculate the grand mean. We have to find out the difference between mean and grand mean. And then we have to multiply them by the number of data values in each column, sum them up as a total. So what we are getting is the SSC. And on dividing SSC by K minus 1, K means the columns. So here if I divide SSC by K minus 1, here actually I was looking for, here we are talking about K samples, but the actual correct thing is written over here. K is the number of groups being compared, means number of columns. You can take it as C also. If we have how many columns are given here that we are going to compare, then after calculating SSC, if I divide by K minus 1, which is a degree of freedom between the columns, so I will get the value of MSC. Now here, one of the important thing that you have also to note down is the degree of freedom, because it is different from MSC. It will be different from MSE, and finally, for the total one. Correct? So here we have based upon columns, so we have taken K minus 1. Now we have the next thing, total sum of square. We are talking about SST. Now, as we have seen, SST can be calculated with the help of SSC plus SSE. But till now, what we have learned is how to calculate SSC, and now we are going to calculate SST. Actually, SST is equal to the sum of these two things, and we have not to calculate it separately. But here I'm going to tell you the procedure for SST, because what I'm going to adopt is after calculation of SSC, we are going to calculate SST, which is easiest to calculate as compared to SSC, and then we can calculate SSE as the difference of SST and SSC. Oops, you're getting it. We have a relation, SST is equal to SSC plus SSE. As might be you have seen in the table, we require to calculate SSC, we require to calculate SSE, and then we have to calculate MSC and MSE also. Correct? But here I'm saying, let us calculate SST, which is easy to calculate. So that after calculating SSC, if I calculate SST, then finding out the difference of two will give me the value of SSE. It's your choice. Either you can go for directly of SSE or SST. But here I'm going to tell you the way that I used to do, because I feel that it is easy. Okay. So how we are going to calculate is, the SST is given by summation of xij minus the grand mean whole square. If I tell you how we are going to do is, suppose I have here three columns for the variety A, B and C of seeds as a treatment. I have done with the calculation of SSC, finding out the means, finding out the grand mean and so on, whatever things we have done. Now what I will do is, I will create three more columns. What I will do here is, I will take each data value and find out its difference from the grand mean and write down here. For next value, difference of value, xij represent the value, the data value in the first column. Means for whatever the data is present over here in the table, I will subtract each of the value from the grand mean and write down here the difference square. Because we are using the calculator, it's very easy to do. No manipulation is there. And after that, I will get these three columns as the values. And if I sum all of them, whatever I am getting is the SST. Let me repeat what we have done. Till now, we have calculated SSC. SSC means, first I have to find out the means, I have to find out the grand means, I have to find out the difference of mean, grand means, make their square, multiplied by N1, N2 and N3, how many columns are there. Next, we need to calculate SSE, but we are not going to calculate it. I'm going to tell you how to calculate SST. I will tell you actually, but the procedure that we are going to adopt is that after SSC, calculate SST. How SST is, you have to create this number of columns which are given to you in the same number. But here we are going to calculate difference of each value, which is represented by xij, the difference of each value from the grand mean and make them square. So the new three columns will having all these deviation squares, sum of square of the deviations, and we are going to sum them up. Whatever the data values are coming, we are going to add them all to find out SST. Now these things are extra. We are not going to deal with it. These are extra because we do not require MST. Correct? We are not going to deal with it. We just require the SST value. And now if we talk about within columns, it is SSE, sum of square due to errors within the sample. And we are saying that it is a measure the difference between the samples, which is just due to chance. So if we have to calculate it, if you are interested. So this is how we have to calculate it. Here, J bar means we have to do the thing from the first column, because we are going to work within the sample. Find out the difference of each value of the first column with its mean and sum them up. It's also near about the same thing. But here, actually, we have to deal with 1-1 columns. And if we talk about SST, there what we have done, we have taken the subtraction from a common entity. Okay? So here also you can do, if you want to calculate SST, you have to take all the data values in one column and take the difference from its mean. Sum them up after squaring them, and that will give you the value of SSE. Now, what is the degree of freedom from MSE? We have K as the number of groups being compared. It means we have the number of columns as, let me take, we have taken till 3. So this is first column, second column, third column. So C is equal to 3. Let me take in each of the column, we have 5 entries, 3, 4 and 5. I have just taken it fixed. You can take it varied also, because it depends upon the situation. But normally in the exam also, we will give you with the common value of the n. The number of data values will be same in the 3 or 4 columns. So here if you talk about five values are there in each column, so total number of values will be 15, so n will be 15, the total number of data values. So here if you talk about the degree of freedoms within the sample will be n minus c, which is 15 minus 3 given by 12. Okay. Here I have also noted down that I have, I'm going to show you how to do the calculation of SSE is equal to SST minus SSC, but you can also do like this. Okay. Now the last step is, because we have calculated SSC, SSE, and then after we have calculated SSC by C minus 1 as MSC, SSE by N minus C as MSC. So after doing the calculation of MSC and MSE, if I divide the two things, then whatever we are getting is F value. And this is the last step of the calculation. Then after we need to make our decision. Now how to make the decision is, here also whatever the bold thing I have written is important. What we are saying is F test statistic follow the F distribution with K minus 1 degree of freedom corresponding to MSC in the numerator. Here K C minus 1, the same thing. And N minus C degree of freedom corresponding to MSC in the denominator. As we know, for F, we need 2 degree of freedom for the standard value. So here the degree of freedom will be C minus 1 comma N minus C. And if I have the standard value, then the decision criteria is same, that if the value of calculated F is more than the F standard, then H0 will be rejected. And if it is less than the F standard, then H0 will be accepted. Right? So you can assume that we have taken here about 1 hour, more than 15 minutes in learning the whole process. So that's why I was asking for the extra time from you so that we all can do it together. Because if this much I'm going to talk in the next class also, then obviously it's a waste of time and energy both. Okay? So this is the last step.
We have ma'am, can you please repeat that? Ma'am, what is, ma'am, for what criteria it is accepted and rejected, ma'am?
It is the same thing. Let me repeat. We have calculated the F value. So whenever the F, let me write down on zooming it, just a minute. Here we have calculated F. So if we talk about the decision is based on the same line as we have done earlier for hypothesis. We have calculated F. If the calculated value is more than the F standard, then in this case, H0 is rejected. The hypothesis is rejected. And if we have the F calculated less than the F standard, this is just the same thing we have done in all other tests. No? Then when we have less than F standard, then H0 is accepted.
Yes, ma'am.
So the decision criteria is still the same. There's no change in the decision criteria. But yes, here, in order to reach that value, we have to do a lot of calculation. And the calculation is actually not so much, but yes, the steps are a lot. And the main thing is to understand the thing. So here we have finally, after doing the things, if you have calculated SSC, SSC and SST finally, then always whenever you are doing with the ANOVA, you have to create a table. And let us see what the table is, because it is also very important. You have to create a summary table on basis of which, because obviously when examiner is going to check if it is subjective part, examiner will not be able to see the internal manipulation so carefully, but he or she used to concentrate upon the final table because it is easy for them also, whatever the student has done. So here we have to write on the heading. The first heading is source of variation. And as we know, source of variation means what we are going to do is under the two headings between columns. Now it is very clearly you have to write down these are the treatments. And within the column, which is due to the error, we used to write down like this. Okay? Then for these two, what we have calculated is sum of squares. Again, sum of square, you have to just write down SSC, SSC along with their values, whatever you have obtained. you must have to write down. Then we have degree of freedom. Now there is, it's your choice to write down these things, n minus 1 or n minus 3, or you can directly write down that depending upon how many treatments are there, how many columns are there, column minus 1 is the degree of freedom for between columns, and if n is the total value of the data, then n minus c is the degree of freedom within columns. And this total is actually extra thing, it's not required over here, but yes, we are going to write down. So here we have the total, if I do, it will be n minus 1. Then we need to calculate MSC and MSP that we have already calculated. We will write down the values over here. And finally, you need to calculate F. So if you have done all the things correctly, so obviously you will get the correct value of F, and then you will have to make the decision. Hanjibitan.
मैम मिडटर्म्स में मतलब मैम उससे कैसे क्वेश्चंस आएंगे मैम, लाइक डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम पूछ सकता है मैम एसएससी एसएससी देख के?
सो आई एम कंसंट्रेटिंग ऑन द थ्योरी ना, न्यूमेरिकल आने के बहुत रेयर चांस है, बिकॉज़ वी कांट आस्क यू द कैलकुलेशन टू बी डन, बट यस वी कैन आस्क यू नंबर ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट्स आर दिस मच, दीस मेनी आर द डेटा वैल्यूज, देन व्हाट इज द डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम. We can ask you to calculate MSC value when SSC and SSC are given to you, because if the student has a knowledge of degree of freedom, then only he can do. And again, whatever the theory part we have covered, that what do you mean by treatment, what do you mean by factor, which of the following is a one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, what is the assumption of ANOVA, which are incorrect, which are correct, like this.
Yes, ma'am.
So from whole theory, you have to go for the definitions and the important concepts. And according to me, each and everything is important. Now I think I'm talking continuously from near about 55 to 60 minutes. Let me take this 2 to 3 minute break, and exactly after 2 to 3 minutes, we are going to start with the numerical. Today we will do one numerical as a whole on Excel. This is what the example is. Till then, if you do not want to take the break, you can read it. These are the data values I'm going to take. And ये पूरा आपका उसमें चलेगा एक्सेल में. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू सी हियर आई हैव डन नथिंग, इट इज जस्ट एग्जांपल वी आर गोइंग टू रीड एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व इट टुडे. देन आफ्टर वी हैव वन मोर एग्जांपल दैट यू पीपल हैव टू डू एंड आई विल चेक इट व्हेन यू विल शो मी व्हाट द रिजल्ट्स यू आर गेटिंग. ओके सो दिस इज आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू चेक नाउ एंड नॉट टू डू दिस, यू विल हैव टू डू एट योर ओन पेस बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली इट्स टाइम कंज्यूमिंग. And then after I will start with the RBD, which is just the extension of the same thing when we are going to add more blocks. You can see SSC is still there, but SSR will also be included. So this is what the content of the today's work. And I think that's all. One example for CRD we are going to do, one example of RBD we will do. And in the tomorrow class in the theory, I will start with the next thing. And most probably we will cover it, but obviously if we are not able to do with the numerical, then on Saturday along with all the students joining, some in the Google Meet and some here, we are going to cover the course. Right? So just I'm taking a pause, I'm also sitting here. It's already 4:03, in 2 to 3 minutes, let me have a water and we'll start with the course. So be sure not to go far, be here, just in 2 to 3 minutes break, I will start. In between, if students have a doubt, you can ask me, just I'm coming back with water.